Hey guys, how you doing? And welcome back to episode number 8 of the Dwarf Campaign on Total War Warhammer. So things look pretty damn good for our little friends in the last part. We've taken Black Crag from the Greenskins, we've pushed them further back, and we've now got a source of gold from the gold mine here at Black Crag, which has then straight away boosted our economy up, and our predicted income per turn is looking better and better. So hopefully today we can continue that successful trend. So let's do this. So Ungrim is just replenishing at the moment from that battle in the last part. So we'll give him a couple of turns just to gather his forces, and then he will move along to the Black Iron Mine over here, which is also going to give us a source of iron, hopefully. Hence the name of the settlement. Ooh, God, I'm astute, aren't I? God. But we can't go this way. We can't go into the forest land. We can't traverse that way. So we're going to have to go south, go past Karak 8 Peaks, which looks like Barakvar are just about to take, which would be awesome, considering that is the Greenskins' capital. So we go along this way, and then go back north to the iron mine over there. And then we'll go south and hopefully hit Karak Azor. That is if Barakvar don't take it first, because they are pushing on pretty solidly as well. I mean, it's not a bad thing because I'm military allies with them, which is great, but I want to take some settlements for myself if that's possible, please. Leave some for me, please. Anyway, right, that's all we can do this turn. All the event messages are being read. And yeah, we shall continue. Problem is obviously with the grudges. We've got 23 in total at the moment, which is obviously affecting public order, leadership, and diplomatic relations. But all in all, in the big picture of everything, it's not that bad for us, because public order is on the up in all our provinces. Relations are strong with the other dwarves, and leadership isn't too much of a problem. So we should be okay in that regard. But we want to try and bring them down as quickly as we possibly can. Because obviously having 23 grudges is not what you want to have, really. It's not good, is it, when the book is full? Anyway, let's end the term. See what happens. The vampire counts are getting closer and closer to me, which is not good. It's concerning me a little bit, if I'm honest. You know, they're starting to put pressure on Zufbar. Avaland has been destroyed. Right, okay. Would the vampire counts take peace? Because I don't want to be in a war with them, if I can avoid it, to be honest with you. I'd rather have them not on my doorstep. Oh, it's moderate. Yes, thank you. I don't want to have a war with you at the moment. So you can have your little petty little issues with Zufbar. I don't want to know. Thank you very much. I do not want to know. I don't care if it's probably annoyed Zufbar with that treaty. But to be honest with you, as I say, I can't afford to be at war with them, especially when they're that close to me. Right, okay, so Ungrim, I think you should begin your movement forward. Yes, I'll do one more turn with you in encamped stance.
What's that? It is 50%! It's a 50% look! Why can't I go into encamped stance? That's bollocks!
Oh, what? Right, you may as well move the whole sodding way then. Oh, that annoys me, because that clearly was 50% left, wasn't it? Oh, dear God. Right, anyway, never mind. So, Karak 8 Peaks is still under siege from Barakvar. We could try and help them out, but... because that garrison there will be pretty solid. Oh, it's actually not that bad. Oh, it's pretty poor, actually. So, yeah, it looks like the dwarves will get them there. I thought, considering that's the faction capital now... it was Black Crag, wasn't it, if I remember. That was a lot stronger in garrison. I thought they would have a pretty strong garrison as well, but obviously not. I'm not complaining. There'll be a few quick end turns here, guys. But we'll get a battle in, hopefully, before the part finishes. Where are Barakvar going with that army? And Karak Kudrin? Putting pressure on the vampire counts, are they? Come on! In the dwarves we trust. Let's make dwarves great again. Right, okay. A shameful display. Diplomatic relation. Minus 10 with Karak Hearn. Or we lose public order. What's the problem? I wish I could check my relations with them, but I can't. And I can't check my public order levels. I think Karak Hearn are far West, aren't they? They're not really that much of a benefit to me, so we'll take the relation penalty. Am I correct that they're far west? They are. They're over that way. I'm not bothered about them. Right then. Let us begin. Let us carry on. Right, can you give me now some movement range less so I can go into encampment stance? Yes, thank you very much. So that will just do one more turn of that just to boost them a little bit further. And then we'll start to go into green skin territory. Black Crag is starting to increase its public order, but the military presence of 12 is obviously making that a possibility. So we can't move these guys across yet. What I'm doing is, I'm just waiting at the moment. I'm not going to recruit any more of these units. I may go for a grudge thrower. We'll go for a grudge thrower. But apart from that, I'm not going to recruit any more of these because I'm saving up. In fact, I'm not going to recruit that yet either. I'm saving up one more turn, and then I will be able to build at Karaz Akarak the armory, which is what I wanted for a long time now, which will give us the Longbeards with great weapons, the Slayers, the Quarrelers, and the Dwarf Warriors with great weapons, which is a massive step up for our recruitment. So that's why I'm just biding my time with my treasury. Sorry, gentlemen. And ladies, if any ladies are watching, why you would, I don't know, but if you are, just be patient for me. I will get there. Zufbar, trying to reinforce Grand Peak. Ambusher discovered Manfred von Karstein! Oh, Lord. Well, he's over there. I'm not concerned about him. War declared between Whistleland and the Empire. Peace between Astalia and Carcassonne, which is probably the wrong pronunciation, but you kind of got there, I think, with what I was going for. Okay, so now we go into Force March. Can we attack? We can't attack. We'll stay here just for one turn, actually, just to see if the fact that I'm there now will encourage them to attack Karak 8 Peaks, which is very important. Oh, God. So we haven't got 23 grudges. I said that wrong, didn't I, before? I said that we got 23 grudges. We haven't got that. We just, the severity of them is 32. So how many grudges have we actually got? 4. 5. Only 5, but the severity of them is bad because we're not writing them off. So I got that wrong. Sorry, guys. We haven't got 23 grudges or 32 grudges, because that'd be horrendous if we did. So occupy the following settlement. Maybe in time, obviously. Destroy the following lord in battle. Too far away. Grimgore. Too far away. Too far away. So yeah, these sort of grudges are not... I mean, I created the problem. I've created these grudges myself because of what happened down in the south, but... maybe in time we can get them back, but at the moment we need to continue our path in the east. As I say, the penalties it's giving us isn't that bad. I can live with them. The public order, the relations penalties, I can live with them. Oh, right, so it has encouraged them to attack. I'm going to decline it, but you shall have all the success over there, hopefully. Oh, so your allies declare war. The aggressor Karak Kadrin have attacked the vampire counts. I don't know what to do here. I'm going to decline. I don't want to go to war with the vampire counts. I'm going to decline.
Greetings, honourable ally.
You're going to try and get me to go to war with the vampire counts, aren't you? Oh, no, against Schwarzenhafen. No. I'm not interested in your petty little battles over there. I've got more important things to do in the south with the greenskins. Okay, so yes, Karak 8 Peaks has been taken. The greenskin resolve is wavering. Moving. Excellent. Their power is diminishing in the south.
Onward to death.
Now, what we'll do straight away, it's a little bit cheeky off me. Ammunition for ranged infantry units, excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Volley fire. We get me odds out. Reload time reduction. Thank you. Definitely. Definitely, definitely, definitely. So yeah, what we're gonna try and do, a little bit sneaky, but straight away try and go back for a deal with Karak Kadrin. Oh, they're not interested. They are completely pissed off with me now. They do not like the fact I've broken their treaty. Maybe in time we'll get better relations with them, but for the moment it's not looking good.
Make your proposal. Dowie from another holder.
Dowie from another holder, eh? Yes.
Talk at me in your crude language if you...
Come on, you seriously don't want to be, you know, at war with me, do you?
Aye.
So Zufbar, okay, we've got everything secure with them. Don't ask me to go to the war with the vampire counts, I'm not interested.
Come then, messenger.
I'm going to offer you a little bit of coin because I want to have non-aggression with you. I want to improve our relations. That's all I'm going to offer you because I need the rest for the armory. Okay, no, it's not worth it. I'm not going to go for any more than that. No, stupid. Right, over here we go. Over here we go. And then, boom, three turns and we'll have a much better pool of units to recruit from. Okay, so Black Crag is plus four. Still, the situation is improved from the presence of the military. I want to get them out soon. I can't leave Ungrim on his own without anyone else supporting him. Okay, that's the last thing I do. Oh, that's a pretty solid force at Doc Coraz from the Greenskins. Oh, looks like they've taken that tower from the... Was it Red Fang or was that Greenskins as well? Bratvar? Oh, that's all I wanted. Something in the deeps. The miners would dig to the core of the world if they could, but this time they may have tunneled too far. The greedily dwarves they are bore too deep into the roots of the mountain, for something stirs, something dreadful. What is it? You know what delves in the deep, Gandalf. Is it the Balrog of Morgoth? Unhappy populace, minus four, negative growth. That's just what I wanted. Flipping great.
Agreed.
Okay, so one more turn, we can get to the Black Iron Mine. I love the references you can relate to on this game to Lord of the Rings, it's great. Bullaloo and Wizenland. Okay, war declared. So, Wizenland are in a bit of trouble here. Peace negotiated between them. Okay, so they need to get that army out of there. I'm going to set them a military target. I'm going to get you to put pressure on Doc Coraz, considering it's quite close to my borders, and I don't like that army there. So get everything you've got and send them right over there now to take them down. Two turns. I can't wait to get this armory done. I really can't. Why is it minus one now? Oh, of course, because of the events. We can increase this to level three, though. Yes, sir. We shall do that. Got eight in the treasury, but it's needed. It's needed. It is needed. Oh, looks like they're coming out. Doc Coraz are coming across. Need to meet them in battle. I'm relying on you, Barakvar.
How may the High King serve thee?
If you tell me to go to... No! If I could only write to you and say, piss off. No. Guild support. Oh, that's good. So, because my treasure is quite low, the guild have gathered together to support me. Trade will surely prosper. 1,500. Lovely. That's a nice boost to the economy. Okay, Ungrim. Oh, we can auto-resolve this one. It is not a walled settlement, so lovely. Auto-resolve. Boom. Decisive victory. Excellent. We shall not sack. We shall not loot. We'll just occupy peacefully. Excellent. Excellent.
What?
So the population, or the public order, is neutral. So next turn, oh, we can build here as well. Iron mining pit, obviously. Sounded like Professor Snape there, didn't I? Obviously. Ooh. Watch room. No. Public order. I think a refectory would be important to have at the moment. I know I can't get any military here, but we can still access the global resource pool, which will then allow us to get the better units as we go along. Because that needs to be sorted out in terms of public order and things like that first before we go any further with military. So one more turn. The eagerly awaited armory is finally upon us. Can someone deal with that army? Flipping heck. They're coming across. Untamed, untouched, whatever you want to say. They are coming across. Oh my god. Caravan raid. The raid remains. Public order plus three. Oh yeah, I can't take another hit to public order, so it has to be you on your own. Sorry. Now we get a boost. Now we've got the armory. Oh yes, Sonny Jim. Oh yes, now we've got the crawlers. Now we've got the great weapons. Ha ha ha! Right. Disband. So if we go to that, does that mean that if we try and recruit with them... Okay, let's move out. Probably call is going to go down, but I'm not overly concerned. So let's disband one of them, not obviously our Chevron unit. Of course, you need to go into encampment stance, do.
Will be satisfied with this.
Oh, the problem is obviously the fact that we haven't got enough income. I take it then when you go to a global, it's going to cost considerably more. Well, would it actually? Yeah, it does. It nearly costs double to recruit, which is obviously understandable. Okay, let's just cancel them. They don't need them as much as I feel this offensive army needs them. Disband them. So we've got grudge throwers. We need to get a couple of them in with the great weapons. Look at the income per turn now. 2, 4, 5, 2. I'm liking the look of that. Where's that large army that was at Crack 8 Peaks gone? They're over here. They've pushed even further on the greenskins. Fantastic. But can you be, you know, doing something about them? I've set the war target on them. Actually, I didn't set the war target on them. I set the war target on the actual settlement, I think. Deal with them. Right now. because trouble looms large. We may have to use this army in a minute to go across to them. Right. Dun, 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 dun. What is your response, Barakvar? What have I told you to do? You're moving your hero about, but you're not doing anything about your army. Okay, peace negotiated between Karak Ziflin and the Empire. Refectory, good. Nice boost to the public order. It's now, is it neutral? Excellent, it's neutral. So now we can move this army straight away. And we can increase that to a level 2 iron mines. Very, very good indeed. More income for our treasury. So one more turn for them and then we can move on to Karak Azul. Sorry about the short turns here, guys, but it's just going to have to be how it is at the moment. Until look at that! The Greenskins have taken back Ironrock. Please respond. Are you going for the mine? You're going for the bit of stone mine, are you? Okay, you will deal with iron rock as well. You won't believe this, but as I was saying that then, I was actually...
Grave news, my lord.
What?
Word is spreading across the land of a dark power rising in the north. Oh. The armies of chaos on the move. They surely plan to invade the world of mortals once again.
Christ. The land.
Prepare your defenses well, for the forces of chaos spare no one in their quest for bloodshed.
The rise of chaos. Dire tidings from the north. The north remembers. Oh my god, doom approaches, and it is only in strength that any hope may be found. Exactly. All these wars we've got at the moment. Crush aborted. Abort! Mission of failure. Mission failure. But yeah, no, all these grudges we've been having. Anger of the Gods, for Christ's sake. I'm going to have to go for that one, aren't I? Because I can't let public order go down further. But yeah, all these little wars we've got at the moment with the Greenskins, with the Vampire Counts, etc. All these relations mean nothing. Nothing at all when chaos come down from the north. Nothing at all. Oh, we need to do that quest battle as soon as possible. I need to get another... I need to get the treasury to 5,000, then I can teleport across and then I fight that quest battle. Let's do that very, very soon. If it's not this part, I will definitely do it next part. Definitely.
I am the Slayer King.
Because I want to do it. There come on. And we need to make sure we're in a very, very strong position. As many, you know, settlements under our control as possible to mount a strong defense against chaos. Because look at that. Chaos rises. The corruption is beginning. We need to unite together. Income from toolmakers. Unit experience. Oh, that'd be good. And quarrelers and thunderers. Yeah. Right, so we've got the great weapon units in there now.
One rug.
Right, we'll just sit tight here. Sit very, very tight here. We'll go for unit of great weapons now. Now we've got the money. And, yeah.
My axe thirsts for war.
Just to make sure we've got enough there. I mean, in terms of garrison as well, we should have a combined, a quite strong force to defend the settlement if this army comes across to attack us. Yeah, miners, dwarf warriors, thunderers. Yeah, we should be alright. It's walled as well. It's a walled settlement. We should be okay. Level 2. We need to try and get to level 3 as soon as possible. What's the population surplus? Nearly at level 2. So we can get to that very soon, hopefully. Then make it a nice, bigger and stronger settlement, hopefully, then. So they're on the move. They're on the move. They're going across. Oh, God. Who's this? It's Greenskin War. That's not what we want. I'm sick of this. I'm sick of these Greenskins. Right, bit of stone mine's gone. They're falling apart. But they could come back in an instant because of the war that's on the go now. Bloody hell, a double army. Top Knots has been destroyed. Right, go for the Krakazor, and then you've got to instantly go across west to then deal with these guys. We can't let these go untouched. Oh no, it's an actual walled settlement. Oh, we can attack it, can we? Because we've got grudge throwers. Okay. I shall auto resolve this one as well. No point in fighting it. It's a decisive victory. It's a one-sided battle, and we can occupy again.
Of Dargo demands blood.
So what can we build here then? We've got a level 2 clan barracks. We've got the level 2 dwarf outpost there. A gate will improve tower projectile bullets. We need to, again, I think we need to stabilise the economy. Not the, or maybe the economy, or maybe public order, because public order is down again. Because, well, then it would actually be instantly sorted out next time. The military presence would then not be required because the conquest would be taken off. So we can go for a, yeah, a brine mining pit. I'm happy with that. I don't need you to die in battle, I need you to stay alive, Mr. Ungrim. That will come in handy later on against Norskan Chaos factions. Rally. Oh, leadership will be increased from that. Missile damage from Quarrelers and Thunderers. No, it's not missile damage, it's ammunition. Oh, it's ammunition at the next level. Oh, which I could get. Yeah, we'll go for that one. Yeah, we'll go for that one. Make our Quarrelers and our Thunderers just absolute beasts. I'm getting concerned now. Very, very concerned. I've told you, Barakvar, you completely, basically, have ignored my request. You've done your own sodding thing. And now we're in a position where we could lose all the lands we're trying to take him back from the Greenskins. So, Ungrim's going to have to come across. And we may have to use that army from Black Crag to attack as well. Here we go. There they are. They're pushing to Iron Rock. I think you try to just sack it then. The migration, every time, every end turn, there's something kicking off. A great migration comes to our borders, demanding shelter from larger threats abroad. Do we let them cross into our territory or turn them away? It's quite ironic that I'm doing this today, this actual recording, on the day that we've left, me as a, you know, in UK, have left the EU. I'm seeing this as a message. It's quite ironic. Be gone or welcome. Well, I was going to vote in favour of staying, so I'm going to... What do I? Let's have a quick look here. Do nothing or do I welcome them? I do welcome them because it would increase growth. I'm going to welcome them. So yeah, it's quite ironic that message came up today, considering I was just recording it on the Friday when we just left the bloody EU. Oh dear. Right. Anyway, I'm not going to discuss that today. Right, so Karakazul is taken. We can leave that settlement to hopefully fend for itself now, because yeah, public order is -4, but it will sort itself out. I'm not too concerned about it. Go for level 2 there soon. Are these events still in place at the moment? No, it's actually making the public order better, actually. That will go with the provincial instability. Yeah, that's fine. I'm just thinking about if it's going to be alright. My axe thirsts for war. Okay, so what we're going to try and do is get these two armies to team up to then pin them down. It's going to be and then hopefully Barakvar can come across at the same time.
As the High King commands.
At least the prices of these are going down. Make this army pretty damn strong very quickly. I may need to get a third army eventually. What will play into my favour though is if the Greenskins continue to just move about like they're doing, that will bring down the war rating. And that second army will actually break away if they don't continue to fight. So let's hope that is the case. Oh, Silver Road. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. So we've got... we can really go and increase this now. Public order +8. Corruption's increasing at the moment. Oh, God. Toolmaker's workshop. Hey, just thinking. I don't know what to go for here. I may go for that watchroom. I'm going to leave it for a turn, actually. I don't think we need to recruit straight away. We can leave it just for the moment. We can use our income on more pressing matters like the recruitment. Well, we're going across then. We're going to pin down these two bastards at Ironrock, hopefully.
Let us begin.
We could have an almighty battle over there in a second. God, this chaos corruption is starting to increase pretty bad. Just thinking about that all the time. That's not what I want to say. And more green skin tribes are rising up here. Right, so Barakvar have gone back to defend Dot Karaz. I'm coming across.
Greetings, honorable
oh my
ally.
God, not again. No. Right, another increase in weapon strength for that chap. Okay, research complete for technology.
For the wisdom of the land.
Right, you need to get across to Ironrock ASAP. We'll take that back in a minute.
Aye.
And then you come across as well.
I'm not gonna die standing here.
Oh, we can increase that, what we wanted to do now, to level 3. Very good. Very, very good indeed. I'm going to go for that one. It gives us the increase from Toolmaker, that tool market, that's it. How are Chaos doing? Are they coming from the north? Obviously, we can't see it yet, can we? Hopefully, they're driven back, but I can see Chaos causing us a lot of bother. I'm sure you guys have been playing it a bit longer than me and will know exactly what Chaos are capable of. Ah, great stuff. I think they were driven back there from Dot Karaz. We seem to have able to hold strong there. Right, so they're on their movement again. Oh, Lord. Right. Yeah. Demand payment. I'm going to ask you for 3,000 gold. Yeah, you won't believe in that, will you? Yeah, no, get lost. Seriously. Is there any way you can stop that? Ridiculous. All quiet in the all quiet the calm before the storm. Right, Ironrock should be a walk in the park. Yes, it is. Sorry about the auto resolves, but it's just no point fighting them, is there? When it's just such an easy victory, easy battle.
What?
I'm pleased now because we've actually come together at this point, and we can now move forward.
Aye, I'll move.
With the two armies together to try and defeat the greenskin horrors. Don't know why I just did that, because that was in forced march stance and I can't go into encampment like I wanted to do so. Damn. I suppose these are going to go for that settlement there, aren't they? So who we got down here? Oh, it's Ungrim. Sorry, Ungrim. Grimgor. How many settlements have the greenskins got now? 12. You've still got 12 settlements. You've got all this land in the south. See, part of me wants to break off to go there, and then obviously I'm thinking straight away about over there as well. Yeah, I need to try and get a third army going, I think, because I'm not too careful. We could be finding ourselves in a pretty dire situation again against the Greenskins.
The slayer in me.
Right, let's just do one more turn. Let's do one more turn. Oh, great. Yeah, that's good, because I've just seen that war army that they had over there near Dot Karaz is actually gone now, because they've been losing battles and they've not been, being on the attack. So that's good. That's one less concern now. At least Zufbar haven't offered me a stupid agreement again with the Schwarzenhafen.
Summon me if you...
Your conquest strike fear great. Into the hearts of your enemies, mighty lord. The wisest amongst them will know that fate is
great.
On your side. I have foreseen it.
Oh, that is good. We need to get across there before they do anything. So it looks like those two armies that are over here, the war army's gone obviously, but the other army's being driven back by Balakvar as well. That is awesome. So now we have to go immediately across back over here to deal with Ungrim. So deal with Grimgore and that other army. Okay. He's being resurrected, hasn't he? Thank God there's an army from Barakvar there. Let's get them to attack, if they take this bloody order this time, to attack Grimgore. We'll try and block off this army, Gordfang Rotgut, and then hopefully, if you don't even win, you can make them weaker and we can take them out, because then I think at that point we really would become the stronger force and would become, or be in a position where we could really be on the offensive against them at that point. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to wrap up the part here. I'm sorry we've had no battles today. I really am sorry. Oh, gem mine. Gem cutter's workshop. Yes, sir. Level 3 for them. May as well spend our money wisely while we've got the chance to do so. Get that income in. No, let's not forget that one for a second. Get that income in now. Yeah, so as I say, sorry there's been no actual physical battles this episode. It's just obviously the way the cookie has crumbled. We've taken settlements though, which is what we wanted to do in the first place. They were easy battles to win, so that's why we didn't fight them. But things are starting to boil up now to a position where things could get very, very interesting very, very quickly. We've got to take out Grimgore. We've got to take them down, push them back, but always have one eye over our shoulder with what's coming from the north. So, obviously, they've got a long way to go, Chaos, until they get to us. But still, they are starting to get closer. So, yeah, going to be very interesting, this campaign. I hope you've enjoyed this part today. If you have, you know what to do. Hit that like button. And, as always, thank you so much for watching. The support you give me is fantastic. And, yeah, much more episodes to come in the next few days. So, until then, this is Warrior Spotter for now saying farewell.